So this is the last part of your governance, last subdivision in the governance portion of your syllabus. So we are going to see today about the sensitiveness of governors, effort, power, and stability. So something like that. Now this is very generic about all types of governors. So that is, in this topic, any governor can be asked. For example, Porter governor or Cardinal governor. So we are going to see in general about all the governors, effort, power, everything, and then we are going to do problems on various types of governors in this topic. Okay. So sensitiveness of governor. Consider two governors A and B running at the same speed. When this increase or decrease by a certain amount, when the speed increase or decrease by a certain amount, lift of the sleeve of governor A is greater than the lift of sleeve of B. Okay. So what does this mean? I have two governors A and B. Identical, exactly. Now when when there is a unit change in speed, the governor A responds more, the sleeve movement is more compared to governor B. For the same change in speed, then governor A is said to be more sensitive than governor B. So that is sensitivity. It is said that the governor A is more sensitive than governor B. Okay. So in general, the greater the lift of sleeve corresponding to a given fractional change in speed, the greater is the sensitiveness of the governor. It may be stated in another way: for a given lift of the sleeve, the sensitiveness of the governor is increases as the speed range decreases. So that is, for very very small change in speed, if there is a good response on the sleeve movement, then it is said to be very sensitive. This definition of sensitiveness may be quite satisfactory, and the governor is considered as an independent mechanism. But when governor is fitted to an engine, the practical requirement is simply that change of equilibrium speed from full load to no load position of the sleeve should be as small as possible. The sensitivity is defined as the ratio of difference between maximum and minimum equilibrium speeds to the mean speed. So how do you do that? So N2 minus N1 divided by average equilibrium speed, N. Okay, that's that simple. So N2, mean speed is N1 plus N2 by 2. So N2 minus N1 by mean speed. So you can bring this expression and put it here in the denominator. So what will happen? So N2 minus 2 into N2 minus N1 by, so this is your average speed, N1 plus N2 by 2. So this is your speed range, N2 minus N1. Okay. So that is a formula for sensitivity of a governor. 2 into N2 minus N1 by N1 plus N2. Clear? Where N2 and N1 are maximum minimum speeds possible for the governor to operate. So that is, it can also be written as in terms of omega, because N1 omega are proportional. 2 pi n by 60, 2 pi by 60, 2 pi by 60 of all the terms will get cancelled. So 2 into omega 2 minus omega 1 by omega 1 plus omega 2. So that is sensitiveness of governor. Next is the stability of governor. A governor is said to be stable when for every speed within the working range there is a definite configuration, that is, there is only one radius of rotation of governor ball at which the governor is in equilibrium. Clear? So that tells you a linear response. When I give some speed, I get some radius, some height, exactly, very definitely. It should exactly be there. So that is the stability of the governor. For a stable governor, if the equilibrium speed increases, the radius of the governor ball must also increase. So higher the speed, higher will be your radius. A governor is said to be unstable if the radius of rotation decreases as the speed increases. If a governor starts behaving erratically or in a non-proportionate way, then the governor is said to be unstable. Isochronous governor. So a governor is said to be isochronous when the equilibrium speed is constant for all radius of rotation of the ball within the working range, neglecting friction. Okay, so you have to understand it like this. So this isochronous will function like a switch, some threshold speed, let us say 300 rpm. So from 0 to 300 rpm, there will be no sleeve movement. When you reach 301 rpm, you will get full deflection of the sleeve. So it is like that. When you reach a particular value, until that, reaching that, there will be no response. After that, you will have a full response. It's like there are only on off positions. Okay. So isochronous governor is said to have infinite sensitivity. Immediately on reaching the threshold speed, it will give full deflection. So it is infinitely sensitive. Let us consider the case of a Porter governor running at a speed N1 and N2. Right. So N1 and N2 formulas, these formulas you already know. So for isochronous behavior of this Porter governor, the range of speed should be 0. That is, The answer of these two equations should give me the same answer. Only then this governor can be isochronous, right? In isochronous, any problem, if isochronous condition comes, you take n2 equal to n1 and solve for the unknown quantity. So that is the condition. Therefore, if you look into these two equations, the only thing differentiating these two equations, everything is same, correct? For both the equations. Only difference is your height of the governor, h1, h2. Right? For two RPMs, you should have same height. Only then the same speed will occur, which is not possible. It is not possible in a Porter governor. Therefore, it is now, hence a Porter governor cannot be isochronous. Clear? Now consider a Hartnell governor running at a speed n1 and n2 RPM. So this is your Hartnell governor formula for stiffness. Mg plus load, that is a spindle spring load, S1. Mg plus S1 equal to Fc1 xy1 is equal to m2. So this, in terms of RPM, I am replacing this omega. 2fc, m omega square r, I am writing in place of centrifugal force. Now, isochronous behavior. For isochronous behavior, I am going to write n1 equal to n2. Let us say, these two terms are equal. So therefore, these things will get cancelled. So just, we are going to cross multiply everything and rearrange. We will get an equation like this. Mg plus s1 by mg plus s2 equal to r1 by r2 is the isochronous condition of a Hartnell governor. Okay. So, the isochronous governor is not of practical use because the sleeve will move to one of its extreme position immediately when the speed deviates from the isochronous speed. So, that's what I told you. It's like an on-off switch. Practically, it is not used anywhere. Hunting of a governor. A governor is set to hunt if the speed of the engine fluctuates continuously above and below the mean speed. This is caused by a too sensitive governor which changes the fuel supply by a large amount when a small change in speed of rotation takes place. Let us say, I'm traveling in a straight line. Suddenly, I have to climb a bridge. What happens? The load on the engine drastically increases. Therefore, what happens? The governor will start giving more fuel to the engine. So, if the governor is too sensitive, what will happen? Due to a small increment in load, the governor will start supplying too much of fuel to the engine. Therefore, what will happen? So, due to the change in load, the engine starts slowing down. In response to that, your governor drastically increases the fuel supply to the engine. Therefore, your engine speed increases too much. So, because of that, what will happen? Your governor will be too sensitive and totally cut off the fuel supply. And again, your speed will come down erratically, and due to that, it will again start giving too much of fuel to the engine. Like this, the cycle continues. Now, that such a behavior of a governor is called hunting. Okay. For example, when the load on the engine increases, the engine speed decreases, and if the governor is very sensitive, the governor's sleeve immediately falls to its lowest position. This will result in the opening of the control valve wide, which will supply the fuel to the engine in excess of its requirement so that the engine speed rapidly increases again and the governor sleeve rises to the highest position. This totally cuts the fuel. Okay. Due to this movement of the sleeve, control valve will cut off the fuel supply to the engine and thus the engine speed begins to fall. This cycle is repeated indefinitely. It is a very unsatisfactory behavior of a governor and this is called hunting. Such a governor may admit either the maximum or minimum amount of fuel. Effect of this will be to cause wide fluctuation in engine speed or in other words, the engine will hunt. This is an undesirable quality of a governor. So, a governor should not be too sensitive. The behavior should be stable. Effort or power of a governor. The effort of a governor is the mean force exerted at the sleeve for a given percentage change in speed. So, what is the force exerted on the sleeve by the governor so that it moves in response for a unit change in RPM? Okay. So, it may be noted that the governor is running steadily. There is no force at the sleeve, but when the speed changes, there is a resistance at the sleeve which opposes its motion. Now, you have to overcome this using the effort of a governor. Okay? It is assumed that this resistance, which is equal to the effort, varies uniformly from a maximum value of 0 while the governor moves into its new position of equilibrium. From value of maximum value to 0 while the governor moves. So, initially you will have maximum resistance and then slowly you go to the equilibrium, you will have 0 resistance. Power of a governor is the work done at the sleeve for a given percentage change of speed. Usually, it is the product of mean value of the effort and the distance through which the sleeve moves. It is just as a multiplication. Okay, look here. Power equal to mean effort into lift up sleeve. So, if you find out the value of effort of the governor and you know the sleeve lift of the governor, you can easily find the power. Formula for solving problems on effort and power of a governor. So, first case we are going to see for a Porter governor. Okay. In case of a portal governor, you don't have Q in the problem. If Q equal to 1, in your formula for finding governor effort, P equal to C into m plus m by G, where, so my P is the governor effort, C is the percentage change in speed of the RPM, ball mass, sleeve mass, frictional force, gravity. Clear? In case you have Q, when Q is not equal to 1, sin beta by sin alpha, you are having some value, then the formula is different. Okay. So P equal to C into 2m plus 1 by Q. Q is there in the problem, right? 2m by 1 plus Q plus m plus f into G, where C is the percentage change in speed, P is the governor effort, C is the percentage change in speed, ball mass, Q is tan beta by tan alpha, sleeve mass, friction, gravity. Okay. So governor power is P into X, where X is the sleeve lift, P is the governor effort. In case you have Q in the problem, then governor power formula is different. 4C square by 1 plus 2C into M plus M by 2 into 1 plus Q into G into H. And I think most of the things you know. C is the percentage change in speed, ball mass, sleeve mass, Q is tan beta by tan alpha, gravity, lift, sleeve lift. Okay, so these are the formulas you are going to use when you are going to do problems on portal governor. Okay, so next is we will see some simple formulas for Hartnell governor. Governor effort in case of Hartnell governor, S2 minus S1 by 2. What is S2? Spring load exerted by the spindle spring at the highest speed, N2. S1 is the lowest speed. Okay, spring force at maximum speed, S1 is the spring force at the minimum speed. So governor power P into H. H is the total sleeve lift, H1 plus H2. Okay, and P is the governor effort, what you have found out already here. So, okay, so this P into sleeve lift is governor power for a Hartnell governor. So it completes our discussion on effort and power of a governor. So it's taken from a Kumi textbook section 18.12 to 18.17.